John Allen, our Washington bureau chief, and Representative Marlon Stutzman from Indiana's 3rd Congressional District. Welcome to both of you. Congressman, I'll start with you. What would this pipeline have meant to your state in the way of jobs?
Well, Trish, it would mean security moving forward in a lot of different ways. Canada is one of our largest trading partners in Indiana. We're a large steel manufacturing state. We're a large manufacturing state. My district alone, the 3rd district in northeastern part of the state, is the 2nd largest manufacturing district in the country. And so energy is critical to us being successful in our economy, and it's going to be important to the country as a whole on a national security level. When it comes to jobs and growing in an economy, the Keystone Pipeline fits that bill quite easily because it's an infrastructure project that the federal government doesn't have to spend a dime on. These are private dollars building an infrastructure, a large piece of infrastructure to help our energy needs throughout the country.
Yeah, and there are so economic and national security reasons to do so. Representative, as I understand it, this would have meant 7,000 jobs, not insignificant right now, to Indiana. John, we know this pipeline means jobs. We know this pipeline means increased energy security. Unions, Democrats, they are all in support of this, at least some Democrats. Unions, we know, are in support, but the president's still out there vetoing it. What is his justification really going to be?
Well, it's interesting. You said that Congress has short-circuited the executive process here, where the administration is considering all of the facets of this. They've been considering it for years now. And in fact, what the president said in saying that it basically cuts down a thorough debate is something you might be able to say. Legislation, and at some point you just got to vote. Thought very interesting today. He suggested that this is not something terribly important to him. Saved some carbon dioxide, I guess, by sending paper to the Senate to veto it instead of making some big announcement in addition to sending the paper to the Senate. So I think the president's trying to play this down as much as possible right now.
Missed opportunity. I mean, Congressman, we keep hearing about bipartisanship and the importance of it. You know, as I said, this is something that actually both sides could agree on. And yet the president choosing to veto.
Absolutely. Democrats from Indiana voted for this particular project. It is jobs. It's union jobs. And that's what's baffling about this. You know, we have a lot of other big issues that we're dealing with this week in Congress, including the situation in the Middle East and, of course, the funding for DHS. And instead, the president is going to veto something that is already passed both House and Senate with bipartisan support. We need a leader right now here in the White House to bring both parties together, because there's a lot of gridlock right now, and this is one of those bills that both sides could agree to.
And yet,
it's
and
important
yet no surprise,
for our economy.
Right? I mean, it is something that you could have gotten both sides to agree to, but no surprise here from the president today. This was heavily telegraphed, John Allen, by the White House, that he would, in fact, veto this. There was a chance a couple of months ago where people were saying, well, you know, maybe. You know, we saw that Louisiana was very outspoken in terms of wanting the president to be on board with this. Ultimately, though, he had already made up his mind.
Yeah, the president's using process as his reasoning. His press secretary today said it's possible that he would still approve the Keystone Pipeline himself through that administrative process. But you got to figure, if he wanted this pipeline built, he would have just let this bill go.
What is it? So we have some, okay, I'm being told that we have some reaction here from the CEO of the American Petroleum Institute. Let's hear what he said about the president's veto.
So there's broad bipartisan support in the House and the Senate. Over 72% of the American public says approve the pipeline. We have one sticking point. It's called the administration.
All right, so how much heat is he going to take, John Allen? You're hearing the American Petroleum Institute saying what you can probably anticipate, a lot of lawmakers on the other side, they're Republicans, saying, is this going to be costly to his party?
I don't think it's going to be particularly costly to his party. I think it's going to be costly to donors. You've got a unanimous consent agreement in the Senate now to have a veto override vote. The only thing they could agree on was a bonanza to get the donors on the left and the donors on the right out there to pour more money into this before another vote. Look, I think the congressman is right in that this was something that has some bipartisan support, has some Democratic support. It is an opportunity, was an opportunity, may still be an opportunity for the president to get on board with something that a lot of members of Congress want. But I don't think it costs him a whole lot with the public. I think it's still an issue that is not, at the level of the overall economy or terrorism or some of those big ticket items that move the popularity rating a lot.
Congressman, let's talk about where we go from here now. What happens next? Any chance that at least during this administration, this will come back and could succeed?
I think that Congress will probably pass it again. I think we should pass it again. If we remember some of the vetoes back under the Clinton administration, they worked through issues. And hopefully, I had hoped that the president would say, you know what, this is a fight that I don't really need to keep fighting and let the bill, sign the bill and let it move forward. I don't think that we should stop. I think we should continue to move. One thing that's helping us from the general public standpoint is that gas prices are low. But that's not guaranteed to be the case, over the next 6 months or over the next year. So we want to make sure that our infrastructure.
This is something where you should be planning for the next 20, 50 years, not necessarily, where gas prices are going to be 6 months from now. John Allen, thank you very much for all your perspective. And Congressman, good to have you here on the program. Appreciate it. Coming up next.